Morning, ladies and gentlemen. My first session is quality assurance and cost optimization in healthcare delivery system. We did not have any kind of an accreditation in India. It is only in 2006 and 7, which I was pushing through quite a bit earlier, that accreditation of healthcare systems had come. It has come because the industries like hospital wanted them to be accredited so that foreigners can come and reimburse their insurance cost. That time I was chairman of a health division of Quality Council of India, so lots of people, including myself, we started off, we made the standards, and that accreditation has come. Now, we are still long way to go as far as India is concerned, as far as the quality of healthcare is concerned. There are hardly 300 odd hospitals accredited, which is nothing for India. 300 to 400 hospitals have applied for accreditation. Now, few of them definitely need a quality imperatives, but many of them are doing it for commercial reason. The right accredited hospital insurance will give them cover, and the persons covered by central government schemes will be taken care of, and some foreigners would be there as a health tourism because of the accredited system. Let's see what is the definition of a quality of health services. It is a proper performance. Performance is the key word. That it means, what is that performance? It is according to standard of intervention that are known to be safe, because you hear a lot of stories in the hospital that the procedures have been done, but they have been led into the complications, death, etc. That are affordable. Now, issue of affordable, I am always skeptical. What is affordable to somebody may not be affordable to second person. A country, as per World Bank report, 40% population earning less than a dollar a day. Now, what is affordable to me cannot be affordable to that. That means there have to be some cost of affordable, but there is also cost of healthcare delivery, and how between affordable the person who is on the street will be subsidized by state health insurance or something like that. There would be cost for healthcare delivery, and that is more important than how you optimize that healthcare cost. I always write and speak about affordability. I have been written to a number of forums, and they also tend to agree that when you say the cost of the healthcare delivery is there, so between that and affordable there is a gap, and that have to be filled up by the state or health insurance, etc. And that has the ability to produce an impact on mortality, morbidity, and malnutrition. You know mortality, I suppose? I know you know morbidity? What is mortality? And what is morbidity? Yeah, morbidity is your disability, disease, etc. Mortality is death. So, there are three things: mortality, morbidity, disability, and malnutrition. This is a definition which was given in 1998 by WHO. It still holds good when you talk of a quality of healthcare services. Quality healthcare is needed and delivered in a competent, caring, cost effective, and timely, and minimize risk and achieves achievable benefit. This is just an explanation to that. Now, why quality in healthcare? Unfortunately, I was talking to yesterday all through my with Mohammed, and I absolutely agree. Firstly, there are no data in healthcare, very little, and if there is a data, its reliability is a question mark. One study a couple of years back said that 98,000 people die because of a medication error in USA. When I was talking to drug controller of India, he said, we have no data. That means it is not the people are not dying because of medication error in India. We must be doing in this much better than the US. More than 98,000 they must be, so we must be doing much better, but we don't have a data. And how much a reliable data? That's the main issue. There are 500 incorrect surgical operations per week, 50 newborn babies dropped at birthday, an enormous defect rate. It is all, as per one study, it is nearly 45%. These are all data collected by me from different journals and different countries. So, these are not Indian data. 60 to 80% cost can be reduced, because when we talk of a quality and the cost, they are all interconnected. You will see that in future slides. 60 to 80% cost can be reduced by improving the processes, and that is called lean. So, you would find there are different models, lean, Six Sigma, etc. So, you would find, as per they started with Toyota production system, they say 90% cost can be reduced, which we don't tend to agree in the health sector. There will still be a waste, which would be essential waste in the health sector, because it's not robot working on a car, it is the people working on the people. So, it is only 60 to 80% cost can be reduced, and that's fairly enough if we can do that in processes. One has to understand the management, work and patient flow will improve, patient as well as non-patient care processes will improve. It's all improve the productivity, bottom line, and the morale of the people. And mind you, in the hospital and healthcare delivery system, 75% of the activities or money which is spent is not spent on healthcare. They are spent on logistics. They are spent on communication, scheduling, coordinating, supervising, documenting. All are these things which come into play. That is the big amount which we are, and it is essential amount. This is the place where there is a lot of scope to reduction. There is also a lot of reduction, efficiency can be improved if we can do this kind of it. And this is one of the, I am very fond of lean. Professor Paul knows about it. I have been teaching it for many, many years in India and abroad. And this is what is how we can look at it to cut down the cost. So, when you say affordable, why don't we cut down the cost, make it more, because every procedure has a cost. And I have told you what I am talking of, a healthcare delivery cost and affordability, and it is something which we have to really seriously see how we can reduce the cost. When you really take a quality concept evolution, earlier days there was hardly anything, people by inspection used to say this is a good quality, not good quality. And I think the best people who knew about quality were the ladies. This is good fabric, this is silk, this is cotton, this is a good texture, this is the color, this is the cost, all that. So, probably they by inspection they were very good, that the ladies was but better than the gentlemen. That's why they go for shopping whole day and they don't buy anything for the whole day, because they are still doing market survey. Next came quality controls, lots of ISOs etcetera came up. And then came quality assurance by accreditation and the middle models. And in the last is strategic quality management is higher up, which we can say your European Foundation quality models, DEMING, benchmarking, all that. So, this is how it has been done in evolution. As far as the Indian health sector is concerned, we are still stuck up to the accreditation level. Some earlier was going for ISO, ISO not specific to health sector. And then some of the hospitals go for European Foundation quality model and Malcolm Baldrige, etcetera. Now, these are the various quality models. If you really go into look into is the quality models, and this is one is the total quality management. Second came ISO. We'll be reading about it in each subsequent slides. This is in a chronological order which I have written. First is a TQM, then came ISO, then came accredited system. The JCI was the Joint Commission International. The JCI was the first one in the US ways thought of accrediting the healthcare services. They put up the standards and you have to reach up to those standards, and they were called JCI accredited hospital. And as I told you, we have started our own national standard. That was only in 2006. This is called National Accreditation Board for Healthcare, NABH, and that is what I told you, it is around only 300 odd hospitals which are accredited. Came the business excellence model. Deming was the one who was born and everywhere, he was a US person, but ultimately when he made a big speech in the Japan, they had adopted him, and he did a lot of work to improve the quality into the Japanese system, and they instituted a Deming award. Not been very popular outside Japan itself because of various reasons, we will not go into detail. Then came Malcolm Baldrige. This is beyond accreditation, beyond accreditation. Malcolm Baldrige is the one which was brought by the USA, and this is the award which was given to all the organizations. When they found it was very popular with health sector, then the health sector Malcolm Baldrige is a separate award which came up. Well, whatever US does, Europeans should do something as well and something different. So they brought their own, which is called European Foundation Quality Model, while Malcolm Baldrige has 7-box model. So same thing they twisted, broken into, and EFQM came and had a 9-box model. We have developed it in India, myself and one doctor who is the person we developed under CII. EFQM for health sector. Again, it has not been that popular. Of course, dozen odd hospitals have applied, and it is some of these hospitals, this is award, it is not an accreditation. There are no minimum standards. This is award. So we started from the accreditation to the award. Then came Six Sigma, too mathematical. So many doctors don't like mathematics, most of the doctors, that's why they became doctors. So they don't want to be precise. So Six Sigma was not very popular into the health sector. I'm sure you must be knowing Six Sigma. What is Six Sigma?
No, let him see. That's the means number of defects within a minute.
How many number?
It's 3.4.
Ajay, you need so many people prompting. Okay. It is 3.4 defects per million operations. So it is amounting to, in health sector, if I give 1 million prescriptions as a pharmacist, then if I do 3.4, roughly 3 mistake, it is acceptable. This gets 6 sigma. People are working on 7 sigma, people working on that. So though you may say 0 defect, but does it happen? It's not possible. We are all human beings, mistakes will happen. So from that angle, 3.4 is acceptable. It may not be acceptable as individual to you, that if I get a wrong medicine, I mean, you can think what the consequences, but that happen. And these mistakes, whatever actions you may take. So, 0 defect, though to say so, even in robot and automobiles is not there. That's why they recall the vehicles time to time, because they have been defects. So, it is, this is what it is. Lean is the one which we have already spoken to some extent, that how we can, this is again Toyota Production System is the one which brought it a concept. How we can remove the waste. As I've told you, 90% waste is there in automobiles. We are quite happy, health sector 60 to 80% waste if we remove, and that means that is the one in the processes, in the flow and the patient, etc. Lean is being applied right from the hospital planning stage itself. And mind you, lean has not been applied, lean has come all over the world in health sector, 15 to 20 years. It has not been very old as far as health sector is concerned. So you would find the lean is the one which has really come up in, and in India we have been Niti Aayog now, earlier Planning Commission wanted, because the waste can be reduced. We started off, so we brought the concept the last 6-7 years, did a lot of training program, some consultancy, but again it is not taken off as it should have been. You can do the planning stage itself, planning of the hospital itself, the lean design, the concept which is there quite a few countries. Incidentally, in Singapore, if you want to make a new hospital, you have to have one lean expert, and it has been well documented. We have made one hospital on a lean concept in Kolkata, Iris Hospital. It is there. So those who are interested to see, Dr. Biswas have been a CEO and a planner. That means at each stage, very small interventions were brought in, and that is how reduction of the cost has been done. And 10% operational cost is a hell of a lot you can reduce. While discharge in that hospital, 15 minutes you can discharge a patient. While it takes in Birla Heart, I have done a project, it has taken 16 hours to discharge a patient. Processes are so. Of course, there are various other issues. Just to say hello to the patient, the consultant makes money. So he wants to keep his last hello to him so that he gets his consulting fees. Singapore, we did some 6 hours to be in Changi Hospital. We have brought it down to 2 hours. And they were very, very happy. If you discharge more patients, the bed is available. But in the Iris Hospital, we envisaged 15 minutes. So we use the technology. So there are innovative methods. We have used the technology and you use the lean, and ultimately you get the output. So lean you can do in operations, lean you can do processes, lean you can do hospital planning, and you can do in inventory management, etc. If you really see how healthcare delivery costs can be reduced. First of all, in the diagnosis, use technology there and use biotechnology. So the technology and biotechnology in diagnostic kits is the one which is today being done. BITS Pilani, there is a professor who has brought out a strip which can give you 1 rupee only, which can give you result on a blood sugar level, which is the one which can be done into this. So there are technologies can be used in a various way where you would find that the cost reduction can be done. You do in pharmaceutical. Now pharmaceutical, lots of emphasis on generic medicine, which is rather than, you know, you have branded medicines. Branded things are always costly because brand has its own name, cloth to anything. So you get into that. Third one is devices. You make the devices, and technology is the one which again has to innovate and find out and be that, and you can reduce. A lot of work has been done in the devices. Is in fact a lot of work has been done. So you would find today for a premature child, you would find that high flown incubator is very costly. So you have simple method GE has brought, and that is the one which can take care of. Kangaroo care, like kangaroo put the child there, so like electric blankets, other blankets, there are lots of things, wooden incubator, this is all well documented, it is not that. Instead of a ultrasound machine, you have interface, put it on the TV, and you can see the GE had developed it. Unfortunately, what has happened is because of our regulation that has not come up. Because in regulation, because you know, feticide for the female child, every ultrasound machine has to be registered, and you cannot remove it to another place. So you can't have mobile ultrasound, you can't remove, and you have to register. Because of that, that has not become popular. And they are 1/10 of the total cost, but anyway, things will be found in the days to come. You would found that these devices, whatever has been done, they are the one which is, we are going to reduce the cost altogether, quite a bit of cost. And we are looking for it, that is what the one of my talk when I will have innovation, this is what a developing country needs to have it. That is what we learn from emerging and the well developed countries. And this is what I need, technology people like you, biotechnology, bioinformatics, technology people, how we can reduce. And that is what the lots of people are making, startups, apps, etc. And they are trying to do that and then put it on patent, etc. According to one study, you would be surprised, on a smartphone, all of you have, I know, a smartphone. Give a guess how many medical apps have already come up in the market. Guess. Yeah, both the ladies. Your guess. Yeah, tell. Okay, I'm just saying guess. Next. 20. Good. Is it like auction, eh? Okay, next one.
I think maybe in thousands, lot of medical apps are.
Yeah, good, good. How much in thousands? What is your guess?
Somewhere between 5 to 10,000.
Okay, very nice. Anybody? Anybody higher up in auction? No? Okay. There are 97,000 applications world over has come on this, purely on the health sector. And this is quoted in my book which has been done by me and Paul. One professor, Anne from Ivy School of Business, she has written a first chapter, she has quoted that 97, she has quoted with reference. So, I am not telling out of the head. So, there are and it all happened, boom had come in 2012 onwards. It is a multi-billion industry now. Now, the US got worried now. Is anybody bringing anything? So, when you say app, it is not, it is health, wellness, everything. Somebody says how much calorie carrot has got, it has got an app, and etc, etc. So, somebody says whatever. So, now they said no, it has to be, we have to protect the people, we have to protect our client, consumers. So, they are going through all these apps now and they have screened 16,000 all apps so far. So, some will be, and in future in US, if you want to develop an app, it you have to register, get the cleared that it is really worthwhile to put it for the public domain. Or it is just people are making billions of it. So, you would find that this is what I am trying to say, and it all happened 2012 onwards, all this. So, this technology is, I always tell in my all the lectures, technology is very good and technology must be adopted. But none of us should be become subservient to technology. You should be master of technology. I'll give you one very clear example. There's a billionaire called Vinod Khosla. He is in the Silicon Valley. He does a lot of work. He came for a lecture in Bangalore and I had a tiff with him during the discussion question answer session because his opening statement was, why do you need doctors? We don't need a doctor. My computer can do everything. Very tall statement. I say you please modify. Computer can aid, can reduce doctor's presence, which is required, which is not, no, we don't have so many doctors. So, it is required to be reduced and computer can assist. The doctor will be replaced by computer, I don't agree. Similar robotics. So, everything today, everything the people want them robotic to do it. Artificial intelligence has come in, etc. Human being can be produced, etc. So, gradually your role is being reduced. So, please still be master of technology and not because that is not really what is going to. So the device is another one. So we have spent a lot of time in device, and this is a need of the day. I must have robust mobile devices which can go to rural population and reduce healthcare delivery costs. That's my aim is. 70% population of India is in rural based. 40% population is getting $1, less than a dollar. I have to see that bottom of the pyramid by C.K. Prahlad's definition, that how we can do it. We have done an intervention in Gujarat. One of my partners is a technology partner, and we have floated a company to do all this, playing around games, etc. And we got an award in Gujarat. Sabarkantha is the district. They have now innovation lab. Simple by tablet. We have put it in Gujarati, various modules of health education, and 500 ASHA worker of the district, government of Gujarat gave the tablet free of cost. We did a lot of footwork running around in those villages almost for a couple of months. By seeing this gadget, she was very happy. This is something new. So we trained them, and that what should be told to the, their different modules, what should be told to the pregnant lady. And she says, she has become perfect how to do that. And her kids have become more perfect. So this is what multifarious activity. It happened when Modi ji was the chief minister. So in our website, we have put Modi ji's photo giving this to ladies. We connected them to the dashboard of primary health center with the doctor, so that every pregnancy get registered. This lady was not interested to give health education to this. Receiving and other ladies was also not interested. By seeing this gadget, this is something new toy, lots of ladies started coming to see this in Gujarati, some video, some picture is happening, and made it interesting, and ultimately this is what was nothing, a small intervention. Impact analysis after 3 years was the institutional deliveries increased, and maternal and infant mortality rate was reduced. Simple, one tablet. And some we can interpose, we can put it in Bengali, same, and the faces can be changed into Bengali rather than Gujarati lady, so you can replicate it. Okay, so this got in anyway innovation award. So let's come back to Lean Six Sigma. Lean Six Sigma, the combination of both is applied. So Six Sigma is applied in pharmaceutical where, or some other places. So this is what is the Lean Six Sigma, and a benchmarking. We don't have benchmarking in India, incidentally. Many countries have. I've been telling people, government is also keen that some benchmarking must be done. But basics have not reached, so what to benchmark? So I was telling people like Apollo Group of Hospitals, Fortis, you have chairman of hospitals, why don't you have your own benchmarking? But they say some of the things which we will do will bring a wrong publicity, infection rate, etc., which is a every hospital, whatever you may do, there will be infection post-operative. I've told you the zero is very neither desirable nor it is. So let's see what is the TQM. When lots of theories came about the TQM, you would find in Japan and other places, there were a lot of confusion. A lot of people came, Deming was also there, a lot of people, other things. PDCA cycle had come. So in 50s, Americans were really at booming in the industry, and their things were known, etc. And at the same time, 50s was post Second World War period, obviously. You know that, no? Second World War happened. So this is in 1950s, post World War, Second World War period. Japan was already having a problem. And you would find their quality things were not known, and they were very bad, and they were in tatters. None of you that old timer. There used to be a picture of old those days. Mera Naam Joker. And this fellow gives a song, Kapoor, the senior Kapoor. Mera Juta Hai Japani, and there is a torn shoe is showing in the picture. That my shoe is from Japan and torn shoe. Probably he knew about quality. That in 50s, that is how it is reflected into the. Anyway, so ultimately, when Deming came in the scene, ultimately 17 onwards, and the Japanese took it as a national pride that everything must be quality, they surpassed American totally in the world totally. You know it. In computer, in Wi-Fi, a whole range of things, and videos, and the Japan started knowing about the quality. They adopted TQM, Total Quality Management Systems. They brought it lean into the Toyota system, and lots of quality models were developed in Japan. You would find that what is really we are looking for? Continuous quality improvement. Well, so many theories came up and people said, what is to be done? There is a lot of confusion. So, a working group was established, and the international organization for ISO, and they said, okay, let us do what is this various theories if we can organize them. And that is how ISO was born. My slide, I am just coming. TQM, ISO. So, you would find ISO is born after the TQM like this by a working group. They brought out some principles, and those principles are applicable even today in various quality models. Now, quality management principles, these are cardinal principles. Number one principle is customer focus organization. In the medical parlance, it is patient focus organization. Earlier, nobody thought of a patient or a customer. They were only worried about the doctors, machineries, etc. What is the need for a patient? What is the need of a patient? Nobody thought. Even in a hospital planning stage, when you really see anywhere hospital was made during Second World War, it was where the horses were tied, doctors were told to make a hospital, or in a prison cell, or anywhere. No concern, he says, doctor should have a stethoscope and he'll work on it. The second issues which we came up subsequently, that means functions followed the design. They say, no, you make a house, you always think of a function, flow function. And then it came up that the design must follow the function. You got my point? Design, you must design a hospital according to the functions. The doctor do, and then you do wherever the hospital equipment should be. But the patient is not there anywhere now. People are talking of patient first, function next, and design last. Hospital is not for doctor, hospital is for patient. That's why customer focused organization. What patient wants? Have you thought of his need as well? And there are lots of hospitals, now they are concentrating, planning in this design, in this manner. So, customer focus organization. Second one is leadership has to do it. Generally, it has to be driven from top, barring of course some of the exceptions I will tell you. It cannot be done unless people are convinced and they are become part of these activities. So, people also, that is like behaviors, organization, cultures, all these different models again came up. You might have read into your management classes that the various of such things came up. Then it has to be the processes have to be done up. They have to improve these processes. And that is why we talked about lean, cutting down the cost, and everything must be developed into system. Typically, a government organization, a person doesn't want to tell what is in his other fellow because his importance will go. So, when he goes on leave, you would find everybody looking for him on telephone. where is what, because system is not developed. So it is very important the system must be developed. It is not a personality oriented, and it should think of continuous improvement. What you have achieved today, tomorrow should be better, day after will be better. So you would find these are cardinal principles of quality of management is still applicable today, what was planned by ISO. Factual approach to decision making. Decision making should not be on a hunch feeling, it should be in data. What is your post operative infection rate? First of all, if your data is not clear, how will you make a decision? Is your post operative infection rate is 18%, and now you have to bring it to 7% is the one which WHO says US and Nordic countries have this 6 to 7% post operative rate. It is being brought to 5 odd percent. Unless where you stand, you how will you take a decision? And then data, how much time the sterilization failed. So when you are talking of a big data and health analytics, I am still talking of small data and reliable data. So you would find that your decisions should not be on a hunch feeling, but on a factual approach of data. And last one is mutually beneficial supplier relationship. No hospital can work in tandem, it's separately. You have to have people who are pharmaceuticals, distributors, you have to have somebody who is repairing your machine. So you must have, it is not that you are paying them, they are working for you, but it is necessary, they should be part of it. Please remember these 8 principles, which are quality management principles brought out by working group of ISO, are still applicable in various of the quality models. All of them have relevance today as much as they had so many years back. Now we will not go into detail of ISO. This is the one in health sector when there were nothing, so people started accepting it. It is just I have told you that 9,000 family means first one is fundamentals, and then second we will not go into the detail, you can just complete it and read it, etc. Let's come to the accreditation system. You would find in accreditation it is never talked about various processes. So that is why accredited system in healthcare was much better than ISO, except those principle we talked is still applicable. So the definition is the accreditation is standard by a healthcare organization is demonstrated through independent external peer assessment of the organization level of performance in relation to the standard. Very self-explanatory, I do not have to tell. We had a lot of problem when we started accreditation in this country. People only knew the fancy word of accreditation, they did not know what it is. So we have to develop the standards. So various people were pooled up, collected, made committees. After that, assessors have to be trained. Then people have to be encouraged to apply for it. And how you will do the assessment, etc. So it took quite some time. From zero level we started off accreditation in the country. It was really a Herculean task. That is why many smaller countries, they have not developed their own accreditation system. They rather go for, pay for and go for the American system called JCI. Singapore does not have his own system, they follow JCI. But Egypt did not have their own system, it just got it only 4 or 5 years back, 6 years, because we were contacted how you did it all this. So the many countries today also do not have their own accredited system. While you can imagine India developed it in 2006, 2007, such a big, you know, of course we did not have hardly anybody who adopted because JCI is very costly system. You have to pay to them quite a habit. So unless the hospital was sure that so many people will come through health tourism route, they will recover the cost, they never bothered. And as it is because of deficiency of the doctors in hospital, you can see what goes on in hospital, thousands of people all over. So your product anyway is being sold. I am talking about private hospital. So why should I worry? I was talking to Vice President of Leela Hospital in Bombay a couple of years back. He said, why should I do my accreditation? This was a couple of years back. Amitabh Bachchan comes to my hospital, get admitted. So that was his benchmark, that if he comes, it is a very good quality hospital. So that is what I am trying to say, that many hospitals never, now gradually, now also the number I have given you, you can see on the website, it is very few in number. Now, how you do accreditation assessment, you have to do documentation review. I will not go into detail because this is overview of the quality. You must understand various models, its applicability, etc. You have to do documentation review, you have to have facility tour, interview of the staff, patient and visitors, and education about standard compliance. I have done lot of JCI accreditation. I was in the consulting group in Malaysia and other places. So you would find many good things were taken by us in Indian system, what from the various accreditation system. What is standard? Because ultimately, for you know, WHO definition I gave you, if you really say, you have to have performance against what, you have to make some standard. Then only you can say performance, you get 98% marks or 90% marks or above. So you have to have some standard and some performance. So these are standard is the one, it is a statement that defines the structure and process that must be sustainable in place in an organization to enhance the quality of care. Now, how do you achieve it? You have to have objective elements. So we will not. We have 10 chapters in national accreditation system and we have 100 odd standards and number of objective elements. We will not go into detail. And every 3 years it is supposed to be reviewed because new things come up. It is necessary. There is also International Society of Quality Assurance which accredits the accreditation system, because otherwise nobody will really take your system. We are still, our standards are accredited, but the processes of accreditation and the training of assessor is yet to be accredited by ISQA. That is why this is one of the things which NABH will not tell, it is behind the lines. But many insurance companies do not take your accreditation system for health tourism purpose because you do not fulfill all the requirements. And that is why the many of the bigger hospital who thinks foreign patient will come, they go for JCI accreditation. That is the reason why should they spend so much of money to get the JCI accreditation. All standards have to be on patient and staff safety. Now one more word is added here is environment safety, which has been added, and every time you must increase the bar of these standards. Okay. Now there have been that quality goes up, people thought the cost will go up and profit will go down. That's a wrong perception. More people will come. So the volume is one which will take you to the bit. So the it is not that quality will increase. Now there are no study except I found when corporate hospital says we spend 1% of total revenue on the quality system. So this is not documented much that how much they really do that, but this is a Western world study that it is very clear that quality goes up, the cost goes down. And when we talk of a quality model, you recollect 60 to 80% cost reduction. Talk of a lean, we are not talking of accreditation, we are talking a package whole as such. So you would find that cost will reduce because of various of these quality models and the profit will go up. So you have to take a quality package as such and not only accreditation, I have got two quality supervisors, two this and this is what the cost it is. So you, this is a misnomer people have to be told. It is up to 11. Tell what time. I can do it accordingly. 11, we will do that. So, you would find that when we talk about quality, it is two things are related, quality and cost. If you see, if you recollect your WHO definition, it is same, affordable cost, that is what I have all suggested, that it is affordable cost which we are talking about, and I said what is affordable. So, these are two related things, quality and cost are related and it is already given in WHO definition. It is always human being we want to improve, we want to do better. And how we want to do better? When I was in my school, I used to walk. When I went to medical college, I got cycle. And you would like to have then car, better car, etc. Okay. So, this is a, we have to have continuous quality assurance beyond accreditation. And please remember two things always. Keep in mind those cardinal principles which ISO has laid out. Second, please also see that you have to reduce the cost. There is no point telling that I have got a latest machine on CT scan, 36 slices or 64 slices, etc. But what is the cost? And cost has to commensurate with the outcome. You find MRIs, it is taken into Tesla, the unit is magnetic unit Tesla. So, the best clinician says higher Tesla cost is quite a bit, that is only taken for research purpose. Because as it is most of the 99% diseases you already detect from the lower cost machines also. And I have told you when you reduce the cost, it will all have to be taken pharmaceutical cost, device cost, initial this, then the recurrent cost and the machine cost, etc. Then only, so it is not one thing which can reduce, it is a whole package which can reduce, and that is what has to be emphasized. Next is the business excellence model. Once you achieve TQM, you have achieved already accreditation, what next? I am already accredited, what should I do? Let me apply for an award. And to prepare for award itself, you would find that these things will be done. Incidentally, we have not done it in national accreditation system, but in the JCI, they have already included every hospital which goes for JCI accreditation must conduct a lean project to cut down the cost. And second one is they must do some innovations. Anyway, innovation has become buzzword. You would find property dealer to tea shop, everybody is writing innovation. So, it is really a buzzword, that what actually it means is something we really have to understand. So, you would find that JCI already adopted it. NABH we have not yet adopted, we have given advisory note to the hospital that you should do this. Another issue is that how do I reach to bottom of pyramids? Those have nots, unreached in villages where government, private hospital, none is really doing. Public-private partnership is not working, how do we really reach and how we do it? So, our own emphasis, many of these, Rajasthan is doing well, the Wish Foundation done something, something else is done. They have taken a public-private partnership in a manner slightly much better. I do not want to go into that details, but lots of things which have been given as a helping hand, like telemedicine, at a state level, they have run a project where medical college will give telemedicine consultancy right up to the doctor at a primary health level. they worked out a business model for this also. So you would find that the best practices that you would find that advices can be given. Of course, there is nothing more important and more good than face to face. That is what, but it is additional aid that if I do not have to travel so much, wait there and get a consultancy, and because 80 to 90% thinks you can handle it, and 20% doctor will also not take chance. He'll say you come, you have to do this, 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 and then we'll decide. So you would find that this is another aid which can be taken care of. Patient safety. As I have told you that one of the studies that 95,000 people died because of medication error, we don't have any data. So what patient safety? There have been very, very different kind of reports are being generated in the media, what all is happening in the healthcare as for patient safety, right up to molestation of the patient, etcetera. You find this in news every day. So how is that? I go for some treatment, and because the sterilization is not proper, I come back with the AIDS because of the transfusion was not done properly, or I come back with the hepatitis because they have not used a proper syringe for injection. So patient safety is very important. Is you can imagine somebody who got like this, and as I have told you, this is one of the things that unfortunately there are state government collecting the data, but there is no reliability. I have gone into in detail in Gujarat, one of the progressive states. Another good progressive state is Kerala, where health indicators are better than national indicators. They are as good as international indicators. So many people contribute for many things. Education is one part, etcetera. The per capita income is much higher because of the, now Gulf has a problem, otherwise Gulf money coming. In fact, there was a study which was done. There used to be more car on the road space was less, more accidents, and ultimately that led into they didn't have the number of beds, the number of private hospital came up, etcetera. There is a chain reaction, and that is because of the better money they had. Patient delight. This is a very fanciful thing. Kano is the person I have had the opportunity to hear him twice in India. He was invited once by CII, where I was a health, national health member, and second time he was invited by somebody else. So I had opportunity to listen to him for 1 hour. In Lean, in many other places in a health sector, Kano's model is that you beyond expectation you get something. Now visualize, they you may add here innovation, you may add anything, whatever you feel like. We didn't have a mobile telephone. Today number of mobile telephone is much more than static telephone in India. Then came smartphones of various version, isn't it? So you would find that earlier when mobile came in India, set was costly, and the connectivity was 24 rupee per minute, because I came from the United Nations, so I wanted to have one here which I was using it there, so it was just more for a shosha, probably not that much of utility I found, because the density of the telephone those days was much less in India. Well, today will you like to flung your mobile? I don't think so. Your driver has got it, maid servant has got it, so there is no delight. Probably that time it was delight that I have got this. Come to health sector. You go and give your blood. This was a model for investigation, and you will get the result. Go in the evening or next day to collect your result. First to give your blood, second to get your result. Then you go to consultation by the clinician. What happened? Somebody innovated it, and somebody thought how we can do this, and think of principle one, customer focused, patient focused. He said, why can't I send somebody to at home? You bringing an aged person from top floor, then go in a car, two people supporting, go there, give your blood, then come back, second time for consultation. Somebody comes and collects it and charges 40 rupees only. Much better. This is one of the innovations, and probably beyond my expectation, and that is what it is, what you can subscribe beyond expectation when you do something is what is a Carnot model talk about. Then you don't have to collect the result. You can collect, put it in the evening, you can access by internet, isn't it? That's it. I was talking to Dr. Lal, I said, no, you make it slightly better. So, what is your excellence today or will become routine tomorrow? So, it is one fellow started, now every lab is doing it. So, you have to look for something beyond every time. That is what delight is. Every time you look something which delights me as a patient. So, Dr. Lal, I told him, why I have to wait till 7 o'clock to get my result? Many of these results would have been done by lunch time. He said, yes. So, he contacted his IT fellows. Now, moment your result is ready, you get a SMS. Your result is ready, you can access your result. So, if there is urgency, etcetera, you can always find. So, this is what I am trying to say, that you have to have patient focus, you have to innovate something, and you can give a delight to a patient. And that delight was is today will become routine tomorrow. Then you look for another delight, and that's what the continuous quality improvement is. Got it? Fine. Then the benchmarking will talk. So you would find that ultimately this is a model. Lot of engineers and manufacturers tell us input process output, and I always have argument on this. This model was in 1956. Dr. Donabin is the one who brought it, who was a public health expert and he was a doctor, and they don't believe it. I say it is there. He is the one who brought the definition of health quality, written more than 100 odd books and chapters and papers. He is the one who brought this as a doctor. Now, manufacturing people are claiming they did it and they are teaching us. So, that is it. It is a historical fact. He is no more now. So, input process output was his. And process will depend on what kind of information you have. Then only you can tinker. Your information is that your waiting is 3 hours, I want to reduce to 2 hours, this information, then only you will tinker to the process, not on a hunch feeling. Again go to that, your decision making on a factual facts. And the lean is all about it, how you tinker the processes. And that is what again I have told you, 60 to 80% reduction can be done, 80 to 60% reduction can be done of the cost or removing the waste, and it is on processes. So, it is one of the very important, which is Dr. Donabin's model, input process outcome. And all, I am not interested what you are doing as a patient, I am interested in my outcome. I am interested, I gave my blood and when I am going to get the result. I am not interested what Dr. Lal or somebody doing it, SMS coming, not coming. I want the result, earliest and qualitative result. That's it. So, you would find when input is there, maximum tinkering is done in the processes. Some would be that how you can reduce the input to reduce the cost, and I am interested in my outcome. And information will play on all three places. At input, you need information, data. At the process, you need information and data. Then only you can improve the input, then only you can improve the process. Outcome, you again need information. What do you do at outcome level to improve the things in future? Yeah, Mohammed. What do you do at outcome level to improve things further in future? Yeah.
Better quality.
Huh?
Better quality.
How? By saying say better quality, is it sufficient? Yeah.
Comparing the results, which is coming out.
What else? Anybody? Anybody want to try your luck? Hmm? This side? Feedback. Simple feedback. That's why you do surveys, feedback, outcome, impact analysis. It's all outcome driven. You got to see how outcome can be improved. You have to have a data. The data will be feedback by not only by patient, also by employee. Sometimes they give wonderful idea. On that concept came up with the quality circle in Japan. The people decide what is the best method based on various inputs. So outcome can be improved by collecting data, by feedback mechanism. Feedback is taken by from patient, patient's relatives, from the employee, doctor, paramedic, etc. And best people to give you feedback are those who are the grassroots level and floor level, not somebody on top. He can tell you that if you use this kind of a broom or you use this kind of a detergent, this is much better. What are the studies which is to reduce hospital infection rate? Were done in Japan, where the lower level cleaning people told that no need to waste your detergent, which is a costly, simple soap and water. I mean, earlier fancy kind of a, you know, solutions. Even now people are using it in corporate, big some smell comes that you used it. Simple water and detergent. The other one, you don't kick up the dust by brooming it. Suction, if you don't have suction, swap it, wet floor. And that is what the quality circle of the Japan, etc., etc. So, get wonderful ideas from the people who are working with them, they can give you. Now, another issue which I would like to emphasize here, at top level we all have a tendency, I am the great, I know everything, others don't. So, if the feedback is taken and you are not taking any action, and if you are taking any action, you are not to convey to the person who has given this feedback, you are not even thumped his back, your feedback mechanism and loop will close. Ah, there is no point telling them, yeah, they are duds, why should I write? So, it has to be analyzed, accepted, not accepted, and person informed who gave this feedback, then feedback mechanism will work. It is very necessary to improve the outcome. This is looks very simple, that you have to do all this in any organization. I am talking about the hospital. Person in reception desk or somebody registering can tell you the problem much better than somebody sitting in the CEO's office. He will know this is what it is, how we can do it. The concept of a filter clinic, that why something which is again in Arvind Eye Hospital some concept, why somebody should do something which can be done by somebody else at the lower level? Why you I come there and I say, okay, I have been told to get your blood pressure done 3 days, why a doctor has to do it? It's not a big thing, technician can do it. Paramedic can do it, and also nurse can do it. Why doctor should? We are already short of doctors. As per WHO, you must have one doctor for 1000 population. India has one doctor for 1600 population, and out of them 70% doctor in urban setting, where only 30% population lives. So 70% population which is in the village, only 30% doctors are there, and that too they are one which are not very, not a specialist or otherwise. So you can imagine lots of these primary health center etc. are not fully manned by these people. So we got to have method by which, and that is how it is that filter clinic concept came. Anything and every parameters which is already there. And then the blood pressure is taken, recorded, the pulse is taken, everything is done. One odd thing the doctor can see, and this can reduce the time, and doctor time is available for the next patient and less waiting. This is called filter clinic concept. In a bigger hospital must be adopted. A smaller hospital is different, but the bigger hospital must be adopted. So far so good. Any doubt? Okay. So you would find many of these things you may like to do to improve the efficiency of the healthcare delivery system. Okay. Now what we need a patient focused hospital. Must think what is the patient's current need, what is the future need, and how you come up with the patient's expectation. So we have to know implied needs and expectations. And I have already told you many of these things as explanation when I was talking to you. We have to also, I have already told you, feedback system by which you can say how much patient needs are being met at present and how much more we have to do. Now, what is actually is efficient processing of patient complaint. I have already told you feedback will close if you do not take the action on complaint or suggestions or feedback. And second one is person to be, must be told this is what can be done, has been done. This is, we are in process, this is difficult because of this, then he will give you more feedback. If you do not do that, last time also I put my thing on that box, nothing has happened, forget it. So this is necessary that, and if it is very good, you may even thump his back and say this was his suggestion which is implemented and has brought a wonders. Okay. Now if you really see what is the, as we are progressing, your next generation patient will be different than what was our older generation. I always say Dr. Google teaches you so much that he many times is well informed or better informed than the doctor himself. So he has to update himself, not like older generation doctors to update, otherwise he or she will say, if a lady that I have got a fibroid uterus, why you have to remove my uterus? These are four more options available, enucleation to this, that, etc. They are so well informed. So the next generation, because the information overload, information available to you or to the each, that they are better informed and they can question the doctor's judgment. And they would like to know why it is, after it is my body, why it is then. That is the second one is that they do not have time. They do not have time. They are ready to pay the price because they have, I am not talking of a non-affordable kind of a group or that, but generally medium group or high tax heavy people or a business. They do not want any risk, they want the best treatment. They do not want to waste time and they do not want to have a psychological problem. that I have to attend my office, I have to attend this, I have to do that. Everything must be fixed earliest. Cost is not much of issue. These are kind of patients you would have. You would find in a traditionally earlier, it was a top management, then the middle management, then the functional management, and employee was the down. Any organization, including hospital, this is a traditional approach of handling patient. Patient is missing in this. No patient, because the patient was not thought of. He will come, we will treat him, he will go. But now the patient is inverted triangle. Patient on top, and you would find next employee, then the supervisor, and the top is the person, top management should just by the way it has dropped and nothing. So, this is what the total quality management concept we have to accept. I am trying to link up the healthcare and hospital with various models we have gone through now. So, in next 10 minutes or so, I will try to link up all that. Okay. Not that we will give a champagne to the patient in the hospital, but though I believe there are some country abroad, Nordic country, I believe they give champagne or something, bar, no, okay. I mean, maybe US then, I do not know, somebody told me, I have no idea. Of course, he has shown me all his hospitals in Finland, but could be or could not be, US can do anything anyway. Fine. Ultimately, what is really we matters? I have already told you, exceeds the patient expectations or delight, Kano's model. That was the champagne bottle. So, it all depends after couple of years what model you want to adopt, which hospital you want to be. There is a hospital in Gurgaon, Fortis Hospital, they call it themselves a 7-star hospital, where there is this small spa, you can have your hair dressing done, the small PVR picture where 80 people can sit and see that, and you can have a shopping center of a branded thing. I do not know they come for treatment or they come for otherwise, but they are there. So, you can have your all kinds of spa and costly, etcetera. So, you find half of the Middle East patients are found there only. They get a medical visa and then enjoy life, etcetera. Anyway, so you require a patient safety. I have already told you, you can transmit HIV, you can transmit hepatitis. The wet and very smooth floor, patient can have slip. The child can be lost. Baby swapping is another one, molestation another one. All this you would find patient safety norms in various hospitals in India, how they are being flouted, how they are being done, and there is no record. Occasionally you find in newspaper, this is what ward boy had done it, and this is how with the female patient, etcetera. These are all come up, stories come up, there is no data. So, very important, WHO has added the patient safety, environmental safety must be in each hospital agenda. JCI has adopted it. We have adopted it, but we have only adopted it. That is it. Nothing beyond. Employee safety, the person also, if he gets the prick and treating HIV patient, he or she can get hepatitis or HIV himself or herself. So, employee safety is another, radiation factor is another one. So, you got to look after all this, environmental safety. Bio waste management thing came up because of public interest litigation in the court, that the act came up, how you dispose of the bio waste. Otherwise, you find half of the bio waste when it was disposed of, either rag picker children are picking it up, playing with the syringe and probably infect themselves, and dogs taking away the placentas, all kinds of things. Now, at least legally they are supposed to do that, that is environment. And that is how you would find incinerators were banned in Indian hospital, which were there earlier. because they have, nobody was segregated. They will push all kinds of plastic syringes which have dioxin and furoxin in the environment, which are carcinogenic. So it was banned in India. Insulation, otherwise old hospitals were there. First hospital, there was nothing. They just throw it somewhere. Second group which came when the things started tightening up, the knowledge was not that much. So people came up with incinerators. This happened only 10 years back, 12 years. Now that is banned. And there is a proper act, legally you are supposed to do it. So you would find patient safety, employment is empty, and well, all these accreditation standard have imbibed these things. Recirculation of water, green hospitals, and various other things are coming up now. Newer things, smart hospital, intelligent hospital, everything is coming up. And I was talking yesterday that every technology has a problem. Your smart hospital and intelligent hospital is okay, but if you don't have cyber security, somebody from distance can alter all electronic medical record and you will find a wrong medicine is being given to the wrong people. So that this have been reported in foreign hospitals in a couple. So you would find as technology comes up, there will be good point, there will be bad points. You have to look after that also. Now let us see what are the international quality model. I will not go into much of detail. The Malcolm Baldrige National Quality Model Award, it is award, it is US, and Deming was Japan, and the European has a European Foundation Quality Model. This is a typically European Foundation Quality Model, which in India we have developed a health sector model. I myself and one more PhD doctor engineer like you. It has talked about leadership, people, strategy, partnership, people result, customer results, key results. So you would find what we have talked. An Indian hospital, when they applied for this award, when I prepared the assessors and I went, they were lacking in two things. Basically, they were lacking in two things. They never have any strategy. Whatever boss has said, whatever owner has said, that's our strategy. And strategy changes time to time. I mean, short. I was reading about. Earlier I used to teach strategic management in the healthcare system. You would find different countries have different yardsticks. We only had 5-year plans. Nothing. Now we are talking of 2030s and 2050s, etc. US has a plan, a strategic plan for 25 years. And I was reading something, Japan goes up to 100 years. They are thinking when fossil fuel will go, how vehicles can run. I was talking to somebody who was a guest speaker from Japan, how vehicles will run on water by breaking hydrogen and oxygen. They are also thinking even water will go, how we can extract oxygen and then can run these from that vehicles, etc. Anyway, so the hospital obviously don't have the kind of a strategy. So this was very, very weak point this hospitals have. I'm talking of the corporate hospital, big names what you have in India. So this is one thing which, second one is if you see here, learning, creativity and innovation, this has been added on. Is a part of this model. This was not existing. You were cutting down the lean cost, learning, creating, creativity, innovation. And that is why 2 years when I did assessment, none of the hospital got award, they just got certificate. Certificate of excellence, but no award was given. So this is something which has been, let's see the lean healthcare. Overview. I'm coming down, you know, the first slide TQM to this. I have come to lean, and very shortly I'll be on benchmark, and then we'll close it. So lean is the one which is reducing defect, reducing turnaround period in errors in laboratories. You can read it through. There's nothing great. Operation theater, reducing changeover time, increasing utilization. we did one consulting assignment, and where Narayan Hridayalaya is supposed to, it is not, it is just from learning stage here we are talking, and they are patterned that their hospital operation theaters, in spite they claim they have done so, is only utilization is 60%. They are not fully utilized. The scheduling goes haywire quite. So, these are all documented. We have done consulting on those lines, and this is what that you can reduce pharmacies and food services, etcetera. These are randomly some of the things which can be done. What really you want to do it is, it will increase the, if you apply lean, it will give a value to the patient and wealth to the organization. And what really patient want these days? He wants a better service. He want, it should be delivered fast to the person. It should be value for the money or cheaper, and it should have pleasing, a pleasing experience rather than so much of waiting, I had a problem, etcetera, etcetera. That is what we have to concentrate in future. Improve quality of healthcare service. These are the challenges. You firstly, I have already talked to you, we are not able to provide the healthcare, very minimal. So, the quality, obviously, we are not providing, so what quality? Next is the quality, and then how you reduce the cost. It is the cost is the problem which every 16% GDP US is spending, is still people are not happy. I have attended where the conference where 300 experts were there. I went from Asia, so I was picked up from Asia because of the many things on the lean we are hitting at, how to reduce it and how to subsidize it, how insurance can, and there are many factors. I will not go into detail of all that. Improved or reduced waiting time, and every experience or transaction should be very pleasing, rather than waiting for everything, including waiting for paying, etcetera. All that we have thought of, that is what I told you, in this hospital in Kolkata, we have integrated, etcetera, and it is possible that we can do it with the, take the help of technology. Ultimately, quality comes, you have to have processes in place, paper. Now, what is there? Waiting is one of the killing factor in the hospital. It is everywhere, but it is more in long period of inactivity, waiting for result, waiting for information. And the biggest thing is when you don't tell the person, he is still thinking what? He is waiting for admission, waiting for discharge. Discharge process in the hospital, word over, is the most criticized, because that time you are not bothered. It is always like a conference, you always welcome people, how they are going to airport at the last, nobody bothers, you just forget about them. All you are worried, same patient, you have to welcome him because he is bringing money for you, but when he is going, nobody. So, discharge is one thing that really. So, you would find if you have cut down the waiting, as I have told you. There are multi-channel queuing theory of operation research we have applied. I had applied way back. So, you would find that can we reduce the waiting to the extent possible. This is one of the biggest bottleneck which we should be able to, and technology will be great help in this. Technology will be a great help in this. If you would find, I was there is one Singh Health, which is a government kind of a setup, Changi Hospital, Singapore. I have read that kind of a system. They might be in US, I have not seen it. I have seen quite a few hospital abroad. I was impressed. Morning, somebody will come. These are the menu at the time of breakfast. What you want to eat? For lunch, these are the options. She will tick mark on palm top. The same will reach simultaneously same time in the kitchen. All the menus will convert into the raw materials, and ultimately same thing will be issued, and the chefs etcetera, they will do the cooking. Every name tray has a name, ward wise they are packed up, put it in the trolley, and the trolley is say A1 ward. At 12 o'clock all the trolley has been put, loaded, it is on the trolley station. These are the one which start moving themselves to their respective ward, and they are hooked up to a plug, so the food doesn't get cold. And if you have not removed the plug, it will make some beep beep noise. Nurse, somebody in the kitchen will remove it. There's a track down below. There are sensors. The trolley will keep going on that. There's a separate lift, service lift. In the sensor, it will do. It will go out again, and then reach into the ward automatically. You find at 12, between 12 and 1, so many trolleys moving around without any help. Ultimately, it will reach in station where it is supposed to be, and somebody will come and plug it so that food remain hot. If they forget after 5 minutes, again beep 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 beep, then somebody will do it. And 3 o'clock is the time, exactly 3 o'clock the trolley will pull back, and if you have not removed, again will make noise and remove the plug and reach back again to this. One of the government government hospital, Singapore, Changi Hospital. Okay. I know Walter Reed Hospital is the Army Hospital in US. They have spent a lot of $1 billion. I have not seen they also something like that have, I believe, but I have not seen it. So that is the excellence we must achieve. Hope so. I will not see, you people should see. What are the various defects? Very important. Medication error, wrong diagnosis, wrong prescription, wrong patient, wrong procedure, missing or incomplete information, blood unnecessary, you are redrawing it, this is another defect, wrong bill, misdirected result, these are the defects. We have already said initially waiting. Waiting is a problem, defect is another problem, inventory is another problem. Transportation and emotion is another problem. Over processing and over production is another problem. That is Timp would I call it. That is how I remember in lean parlance, that all that is something is a waste, we should be able to do it. And that will give a value proposition to the patient. So when you say defect, you must detect the defect first. Then you must eliminate the defect, and third one is you must prevent the defect, and that is what is the waste is red, 80%, 60 to 80% is the waste, and value is only 40%, the green and red, you can see that. Now let us go, this is the last two slides, the benchmarking. It is a quality by comparison for achieving better standard. Suppose we say national benchmark for post operative infection is 7, that is the benchmark every patient, every hospital should achieve it. First of all, they must have their own data and then decide and then reach up to that. We haven't got a benchmark, we in corporate hospitals don't have their own benchmark. Now Niti Aayog, earlier planning commission was very keen to do it, spend money etcetera. But we have not achieved anything on this. Now, when, what are the stages of improvement in benchmarking? First is we are not, we are ineffective, inefficient, at the risk of failing, needs major redesign. I think we are at this level. Second is we should be effective, and third is we should be efficient. What is the difference between effective and efficient? Anybody? It is given, the definition is given in ISO also. Yeah.
Effective is doing the right things. Efficiency is doing things right.
Okay. Further elaboration? What is cost effective in effective is in terms of percentage and quantification. I will reduce my post operative infection from 22% to 15% in next 2 years. This is my effectiveness. How I do it? That means how much resources I will take, option A, option B, option C, and that is called efficiency. At the least resource, I get maximum output result. Bengal is known for endemic cholera. So, WHO did a study, 10 year simulation study. They say if you give safe water, is one. What used to happen? The immunization, when cholera happened, colony gave immunization. 6 months is only effective when you give. People thought, but that was the most costly method. As per the simulation model, every 6 months you would keep doing it for 10 years when simulation were done. So, best is give safe drinking water. Second is safe disposal of feces. And third is combination of both. And fourth is immunization. Best is, of course, combination of both. It will not only subside cholera, but also many waterborne diseases. This is a WHO study done on a Bengal. So, you would find the efficiency is not the immunization, but option 3, option 3. And effectiveness, that you brought down the cholera percentage cases to the. Similarly, it is called cost benefit, cost effective analysis. In health, cost effective is more preferred than cost benefit, because many things, direct or indirect costs, you cannot work out. So many man hours lost, etcetera. Benchmarking, then you have to see best in class, best in primary health center, best in secondary, tertiary care or orthopedic, etcetera. And a global benchmarking, when you say we are comparable to others, like I have told you, it is 6% of post operative infection, which is one of the best in the Nordic or US countries, you would find this. That you are reaching that benchmark. There are two very famous case studies. One is the Toyota production system, where the lean application has been done, and second is Jiangping County Council, which is in Sweden. I had opportunity to have a look at that. It is one thing which was done in 10 years, bottom up approach. People decided to improve. This is there. If you want to read, I will give you the link. So, from 92 to 2002, in 10 years they have really improved. They improved the, first they said what is organization, then they went for total quality management, then they went process orientation and process leader education, etcetera. And then this is how they reached to that stage. Now, problem would be that we have to see, are we ready for change? We have to make people aware that it is feasible, it is possible. That is what very important. If they do not agree, they will not do it, that it is possible, rational method of doing it. Like accreditation, first we did that only. I did 62 one day, back to back, all over India. Government paid for it. I went around, there were nobody else with me, slowly more people joined in, etcetera. We have done awareness program, so that this is good. Second is best strategy. They were also told that you want patients, foreign patients, bigger hospital, you have to get this done. And it all depend what kind of a, like Gujarat even was the first government hospital which was accredited during. There was a very dynamic principal, Health Secretary Dr. Amarjit Singh, Chief Minister was Prime Minister today, Modi ji. And this was a, and now then they made it compulsory every hospital to be accredited. Then they made it also for a community health centers, etcetera, to be accredited. Which one? Gandhinagar was the first. Gandhinagar. But now they have, Gandhinagar, Gujarat. Now, that was the first in India, district hospital. But today, I am not exactly sure, but I think 80-90% of the government hospitals are accredited in Gujarat. They are even gone for community health centers and primary health center accreditation. They have developed their own system as well. The first one was, I was associated, that is why I know it was Gandhinagar Hospital. Then went to Baroda, then went to something else. And now, of course, Kerala has gone for this, and now this is, you know, it is an electoral issue, vote issue. So, they have it, why can't we have it? Delhi has got some hospital accredited, government hospital, I am talking. But other hospitals, government, they are not much. Some state remains so and shall remain so for many decades, I think. Now, what is the quality? These are the, what is the quality? Something healthcare which is safe, effective, patient centered, timely, efficient and economic. And I found this model which I copied from somewhere, quality is in center, and all these things which are shown here have linkages. Leadership to employment, talent, and etc. You can read it. We have already talked about it. In conclude, you have to have quality continuous improvement, think quality beyond accreditation, think of a cost, pursue perfection, pursue. You can never reach perfection in life. You can never reach perfection. There is nothing like, I don't believe in that. One of those management journal has given a good joke. One person after retirement used to sit on a bench after a walk. Then after a few days, a lady also joined. Ladies are more curious. She asked him, you come every day for walk? He said, yes. You stay nearby? Yes. Where are your children? He said, I am not married. He said, why didn't you get married? Because I didn't get ideal partner, perfect and ideal partner. So, his whole life has gone, he didn't find one. So, he asked the same question to a lady. A lady also said, I didn't find an ideal partner. Are they ideal today at that age to each other? So perfection, don't look for perfection near, but look for, pursue perfection, near perfection. Quality is nothing but a common sense. Quality is nothing but commitment of healthcare leadership. And thank you. Okay. Any question? One or two questions I can take, otherwise tea time we can talk, very small group anyway. Okay.
What will the Gandhinagar Hospital message to hospitals, district hospitals in Odisha and West
Bengal? No, there is no question of matching or not. It is not a question of matching, not matching. In accreditation, there are certain standards. You have to adopt those standards, reach those standards. And to reach those standards, somebody has to assess. So, you have to have those, you know, I have told you how do you do assessment, that you do review of the document because data is required. Then you go around and ask the see what are your SOPs, how you are doing it, how you are accredited, you find how sterilization is being done. When you require sterilization, the steam sterilization is the most popular and good. So, you would find in steam sterilizer that if you do 15 pounds of pressure and temperature is so much and then 15 to 16 minutes. So, you time it up and then when you take out a load, you time. And there is also gauge which can give you all a graph. That means the thing inside has already been sterilized. What generally happens in a hospital? Some fellow technician, he says, load laga diya. Whenever you feel like usko ghar jaldi jana hai, they say, load nikal lo, ho gaya. Totally based on hunch feeling. So, that is why they are not proper sterilization done. Then you find that your date of sterilization is written. In a developed country like US, you use it, do not use it, it goes back for re-sterilization. India, we are permitting from the date 7 days after re-sterilization. Go to government hospital, no date written, is lying, LP set is lying for months together. And tell these people that once you open the drum, you gorge, etcetera, whatever you are catching with the tongue and not with the hand, after dressing, once you open it, it has to go for re-sterilization. And typically, if you go and observe in a government hospital, he uses it, he closes the drum, somebody comes, again open it, do the dressing. All these standards have to be met. And your peer group, your should say it is being done, then only you sterilize. So, these are best practices, best scientific practices. So, that way it is that you have achieved it. And Orissa or Bangalore or whatever, they have not achieved it, they have not even tried to achieve it because they find it very difficult, both mushkil hai.